Grubbs test is used to detect a single outlier in a univariate dataset that follows an approximately normal distribution. How is this test useful in detecting outliers? What is the mathematics behind it is what we'll cover in this video. So let's start by first importing the necessary modules. I've defined a simple array called as y, which has values between 149 and 205. I'll show the scatter plot to make the idea more clear as to how the distribution is. So I have most of the values concentrated around 150, and I have an outlier like point at 205, which is visible from the plot. How is the Grubbs test defined? A bit of mathematics is what I'll introduce in the next section. As for any test of hypothesis, Grubbs test also has two hypotheses that are famously known as null hypothesis and alternate hypothesis. The null hypothesis for Grubbs test is that there are no outliers in the dataset. The alternate hypothesis is that there is exactly one outlier in my dataset. For any hypothesis test, there is a calculated value and a critical value. Grubbs test also has a calculated value and a critical value. Now, the calculated value of Grubbs test or the Grubbs test statistic is defined as the max of yi minus y bar divided by s, where y bar is the mean of your whole distribution, y is the actual point values of your data set, and s is your standard deviation. And you have a critical value which looks very daunting, but it's very fairly simple to understand. It's basically a ratio of numerator by denominator, where numerator and denominator are both t-distributions. The t-distributions that I've mentioned, or this part of the formula, denotes the critical value of the t-distribution with n-2 degrees of freedom and a significance level of alpha by 2n, where n is the number of elements present in your data set. So this is the critical value calculation. The above is a calculated or the test value calculation. Now, for any hypothesis test, you have a calculated value, you have a critical value. If your calculated value is greater than the critical value, you reject the null hypothesis and you accept the alternate hypothesis, which in our case states that there is exactly one outlier in the data set. If your calculated value is less than the critical value, then you accept the null hypothesis stating that there is no outlier in your data set. If this idea is clear, then I'll walk you through the same data set that we were kind of going over, wherein most of the points were concentrated around 150 and we had an extreme value at 205. So let's start by computing the calculated value. Let's first compute the mean value, which is y bar. So this part of the cell gives you the average value, wherein I've just used the np.mean function. Now all the values that I had, I subtract the mean value from them to get a deviation from mean. Now, since I have the deviations from the mean, I'll find the maximum of those deviations that are there from the mean value, and the denominator shows the standard deviation. So I use numpy.standard deviation or np.std to find out the standard deviation of my data set, and I calculate the Grubbs test statistic by the ratio of max of deviations, which is 47.99, divided by the standard deviations, which is 18.17. to get a calculated test statistic for Grubbs test to be equal to 2.63. Now, if the whole idea of calculated is clear to you, let's move on to the critical value calculation. So the critical value calculation is formulated into this Python function, wherein I have my numerator, which is n minus 1 into the square of the square root of the numerator term. Similarly, the denominator term is what I've included here. So whenever you get a chance, you can go through the notebook. I'll be sharing the link of the notebook below. So this formula is basically implemented into this Python function called as calculate_critical_value, wherein it accepts two values, the size, that is the total number of elements that are present, which is n in our case, and alpha, that is 1 minus the confidence interval. So if my confidence interval that I am testing the test for is 95%, then my alpha value would be 0.05. So I run the cell and I calculate the critical value. So Grubbs critical value based on the calculation above gives me a value of 2.12, and the calculated value was 2.63. So my critical value is less than my calculated value. What does this imply in terms of null hypothesis is what we'll see here. So we had defined the null hypothesis that there are no outliers in the data set. Alternate hypothesis was defined as there is one outlier in the data set. We computed the test statistic or G calculated, which turned out to be 2.63. We are testing the test at 95% confidence interval or alpha of 0.05. So the critical value for 95% confidence or 5% of alpha turned out to be 2.12. Since my test statistic is greater than my critical value, 2.63 is greater than 2.12. So I'll reject my null hypothesis and accept my alternate hypothesis, which states that there is exactly one outlier in my dataset. This can further be modified or this can be further scaled up to find out n outliers in your dataset and keep the values intact. That is called a studentized ESD test. I won't go into the details of it, but that is the modified version of the Grubbs threshold that is there. This was my attempt at explaining how Grubbs threshold can be used for outlier detection. If you do have any questions with what we have covered in this video, then feel free to ask in the comment section below and I'll do my best to answer those. If you enjoy these tutorials and would like to support them, then the easiest way is to simply like the video and give it a thumbs up. And also it's a huge help to share these videos across with anyone whom you think would find them useful. Please consider clicking the subscribe button to be notified for future videos. And thank you so very much for watching.